My name is Julia Schubert. I am a PhD student and image analyst working with positron emission tomography brain imaging. Although much research has been performed to better the understanding of neurological diseases such as multiple sclerosis and Alzheimer's disease, there is still a lot that we don't know. It has been suggested that reduced clearance of waste from the brain tissue may be associated with some neurological diseases. In the case of Alzheimer's disease, a reduction in the clearance of beta amyloid may be contributing to the aggregation of these proteins in tissue, leading to the characteristic beta amyloid plaques that disrupt cell function and eventually contribute to cell death. We don't currently have a reliable method to measure the activity of the brain's clearance systems, and such a measure could be very useful for further understanding the development and progression of some neurological diseases. One function of cerebral spinal fluid is to carry waste and other solutes in the brain. The brain has several methods of clearing waste, but regardless of the method, the proper production and flow of cerebral spinal fluid are important. This research looks at measuring the differences in cerebral spinal fluid dynamics between patients with neurological disease and healthy controls. We perform positron emission tomography using Pittsburgh Compound B radio tracer on groups of Alzheimer's disease, mild cognitive impairment, and multiple sclerosis patients, as well as sets of matched healthy controls. This radio tracer is used to measure tissue amyloid in Alzheimer's disease and myelin in multiple sclerosis. Recently, it has also been used to quantify cerebral spinal fluid mediated clearance by measuring the signal in the lateral ventricles. We calculated the average signal in the lateral ventricles for each of our groups. We found that the lateral ventricle signal was significantly lower in Alzheimer's disease and in multiple sclerosis groups compared to healthy controls. The mild cognitive impairment group had intermediate lateral ventricle signal values between those of Alzheimer's disease and healthy control groups. Our observation of a lower signal in the lateral ventricles of patient groups compared to controls could indicate that there are alterations to cerebral spinal fluid production or flow in Alzheimer's disease and multiple sclerosis. The intermediate signal measurements that we observed in the mild cognitive impairment group suggest that cerebral spinal fluid mediated tissue clearance is reduced prior to Alzheimer's disease onset. This research begins to explain how changes to the brain's clearance systems may play a role in some neurological diseases. Although there is still a lot more to learn, this is a starting point in the development of a new method for monitoring cerebral spinal fluid dynamics, and we now know more about the changes to cerebral spinal fluid dynamics that may occur in multiple sclerosis and Alzheimer's disease. Thank you for watching.